Indiana leads the all-time series between these two schools 4-0. The last meeting, as we mentioned, in the regional finals in 1987. They also met in 81 in the tournament. Both of those years, LSU lost Indiana, and Indiana went on to win the national championship. Tim Higgins of Ramsey, New Jersey, David Libby of San Diego, California, Bobby Vetketter of Maybank, Texas, the three officials working this one. Purple and gold. O'Neill and Nover to jump it up. We're underway. The winner goes to the Sweet 16. Damon Bailey. LSU opens in a 2-3 zone. They'll switch defenses throughout the game. Calvert Cheney had it batted away by Caesar. Dale Brown wants to switch his defenses because he thinks the key to this game is disrupting Indiana's flow in their half-court offense. He says when they get into a rhythm, they are deadly. Bailey, affected by O'Neill, who grabs the rebound. And a whistle by Tim Higgins. Bob Knight was off the bench and almost out to midcourt. Only 7 seconds ticked off the game clock, and that is probably what Coach Knight pointed out. Certainly this sequence took longer than 7 seconds.
Damon Bailey into the lane. O'Neill as high as he can go, but smartly not going for the ball that he cannot get. Bailey throwing it up over the top, hoping somebody else on his team can get an offensive rebound if O'Neill doesn't block it.
Damon said yesterday they cannot let O'Neill intimidate them. They have to run their offense, take the shots they would ordinarily take. Bob Knight was correct. The clock was not functioning, and they've ticked more time off the clock. 19:37 now showing in the first half. And LSU is in possession of the ball for the first time. Man-to-man defense with zone principles, says Bobby Knight, to describe what he'll employ today. That's Grinnell Singleton with the first point to the game.
That will be a huge key for LSU all day long, whether Singleton, Williamson, Brandon can hit outside jumpers, as well as Caesar.
Allen Henderson thought about a jumper and passed it up. Reynolds moves it quickly to Bailey. Nover. Asa Henderson, deflected away by Singleton and out of bounds. We've seen a difference in Verdell Singleton already. He was bothered by a flu-like virus on Thursday night and scored only 4 points, but he said he's feeling better today.
Excellent strategy by Indiana that time. Go at O'Neill and then pass the cutters along the baseline.
Damon Bailey called for a foul. Let's check in with Andrea Joyce.
Sean, the LSU coaching staff has been concerned about Vernell Singleton's health. He's had a virus the last couple of days that he just hasn't been able to shake. In fact, he felt so weak after the BYU game on Thursday, they took him to the hospital and put him on an IV. They did it as a precaution. He was not dehydrated. They say he feels better and he looks pretty good out there now, but they won't know really until the game goes on. Back to you guys.
Singleton looks healthy again. He has all 4 points of the game. Over. Call for a travel.
Intimidation by O'Neill that time. They're flashing Nover into the lane, who's not even looking for his shot. He's looking for guys moving after the defense rotates.
Jamie Brandon, guarded by Chris Reynolds, who was the best perimeter defender for Indiana. Caesar Long, rebounded by Henderson. Chris Reynolds. Nover, the turnaround. Indiana is on the board. It's 4-2. Oh.
seemed to be receiving the ball in the lane area. That time, the collapsing defense for LSU picked up the foul. It'll be Indiana's ball on the baseline. Singleton off to an incredibly hot start offensively. Calvert Cheney.
I believe my mic went dead, at least. I couldn't hear myself for a while, Bill. And I'm glad that it's working. Vernell Singleton with all 6 points for LSU. And it's 6-2 Tigers. There's Calvert Cheney punching into three, and all of a sudden it's a one-point game.
Good start for both teams, shooting well from the perimeter. O'Neal trying to work for good, solid, low post position.
Williamson picks up right where he left off the other night. He said, every time I got the ball, I felt like it was going to go in, and for the most part, that was true, as he went 10 for 14 from the floor in the game against BYU. O'Neal with a block. The ball came down to Caesar, and he was fouled by Chris Reynolds.
O'Neal, great patience, waiting for Henderson to deliver the ball and then tapping it out, much the way Alonzo Mourning does on a consistent basis. And his players reacting to it, garnering the ball, the loose ball, Indiana has to foul.
9-5 LSU. The Tigers have opened, hitting four of their first five shots. Singleton off the mark this time. That's the first miss for Vernell Singleton. He's 3 for 4. 16-23 to play in the half. The steal by Williamson. He hops to the basket. Six for Singleton, 5 for Williamson. LSU leads 11-5. Over. Gets it to bounce in. Dale Brown hurrying off the bench looking for an offensive goaltend.
That ball looked like it was tapped back in while it was still in the cylinder by Indiana.
O'Neal muscles it up, fouls the basket, and he was fouled by Matt Nover.
O'Neal fighting his way across the lane, finally gets Nover behind him, rolls in, basically just throws it up there trying to draw the foul. So much strength and power.
For those of you expecting to see the Georgia Tech USC game, we'll be sending you to that game momentarily. O'Neal makes the free throw. His first 3 points give LSU a 7-point lead. Welcome back to Boise. LSU on the strength of 6 for 8 shooting has a 14-7 lead over Indiana. 15:35 to play in the first half. Sean McDonough with Bill Walton. Happy to have you with us. The winner of this one meets Florida State in the Sweet 16. Greg Graham has come off the bench for Indiana. He's number 20. This is Alan Henderson. Well short, but he got his own miss and scored.
Vernell Singleton matched up with Henderson along the baseline that time. Never run by the shooter. That time, Henderson able to get the offensive stick back.
Caesar attempted more threes than any other Tiger, and he knocks that one in. Scored a 2-point field goal. They ruled that Clarence Caesar was on the line. It's back to a 7-point lead for LSU. Jamal Meeks has also come in for Indiana. He's running the point now, number 23, and that's Calvert Cheney with 5 points for Indiana. And that's the deficit facing the Hoosiers.
If LSU stays in their zone defense, Calvert Cheney, when he gets the ball uncontested, he'll be able to create beautifully all day for Indiana, giving them easy scoring opportunities.
Caesar, that one is for three. By 5 straight points for LSU from Clarence Caesar, the freshman from Iowa, Louisiana.
One thing that is nice about LSU's offense right now, like Georgetown in the first game today, freewheeling offensively from the perimeter with guys who are supposed to be feeding the post all day.
Dale Brown has watched the Tigers hit their last 4 shots, and they're 8 for 10 from the floor to this point. An 8-point lead for LSU. We've played 6 minutes. Great slam. Chaney went up in the air, but O'Neal batted it away and then ripped down the rebound.
Could have been a foul on O'Neal that time. Looked like Chaney was going for a slam dunk. O'Neal too strong.
It's O'Neal going for a slam dunk, and he's much too strong. Nover gets it to drop in. 6 points for Matt Nover. That's his average per game coming into this one. Brandon to Caesar on the floor with Singleton, O'Neal, and Williamson. The starting 5 still out for LSU. 2 more for Verdell Singleton. The senior from Natchez, Mississippi, has 8 points. Was a third-team All-SEC selection again this year for the 3rd time in his 4-year career. O'Neal over the back of Dover to bat it away to Williamson. And his bounce pass kicked out of bounds.
O'Neal over the back.
That could have been another foul.
Easy opportunity for the referee to call a foul there. That's why you spend so much of your time playing defense before your man ever gets the ball. But don't give him those kind of easy opportunities that Nover has had throughout this game.
Williamson, short. Off the hand of Alan Henderson and out of bounds. It will be LSU ball. The Tigers with a 10-point lead with 12:38 to play in the first half. Brandon. And with that, Bob Knight sends Eric Anderson to the scorer's table. He'll check in. Nover. Blocked by O'Neal. 3 blocks for Shaquille. Williamson saves. Caesar scores. A 14-point lead here in the first 8 minutes for the 7th-seeded Tigers against the 2nd-seeded Hoosiers. Nover, along with it, Henderson had the rebound, and he was fouled by Maurice Williamson. 8 of the last 9 for LSU, and for the game, they are 12 of 15. Timeout on the floor. Indiana down by 14. Shaquille O'Neal dominating the opening moments of this game with Indiana. For Shaq to this point, 7 points, 3 block shots, 2 rebounds, and 1 steal. He's altered 5. He's a perfect 3-for-3 from the floor and 1-for-1 from the line.
So they take him out.
Good chance to get him a rest with your team up by 14 points. Williamson reached in, called for the foul as he hit Greg Graham. First foul against Maurice Williamson. Coming off the performance of his career on Thursday night, his 30 points against BYU, 1 shy of his career high. We mentioned on Thursday, his father, John Williamson, the former NBA standout and New Jersey Nets all-time leading scorer, has been having serious health problems with kidney disease. He got out of the hospital from dialysis treatment Thursday and got home just in time to see Maurice play. Jamal Meeks knocks in a 3. That's his average per game for the season. The senior from Freeport, Illinois, has Indiana back with an 11. It's Dirk Hammack, number 43, who has checked in for O'Neal, and Williamson called for his 2nd foul in quick succession, an offensive foul, the 4th against the Tigers here in the first half.
O'Neal right back in the game. Give some credit, though, to Jamal Meeks doing some excellent work out there, hitting the three-pointer, drawing the charge. Back in the action now after being benched most of this year with the improved guard play of other Indiana players.
Chaney strong to the bucket. 7 points for Calvert Chaney. What was a 14-point lead is down to 9. Brandon, a 2-point try as he was on the line, was short, rebounded by Vernell Singleton. It's the starting five again out there for LSU. Brandon, too strong, rebounded by Anderson. Meets with the ball. He's joined in the backcourt by Greg Graham. Nover alone. Foul by Shaquille O'Neal. First foul of the game against O'Neal. And Matt Nover will have a chance for a three-point play.
I sensed a little change of confidence for Indiana. They took O'Neal out. He had totally dominated the first 7 or 8 minutes of the game. They took him out, and now Indiana hit a three-pointer. They come back. They got a little sense of, hey, we can get it done. LSU, on the other hand, playing a little bit more tentatively right now.
Jamie Brandon to the bench as Nova goes to the line. Whistle for a violation against Indiana. Calvert Chaney was in the lane early. Indiana has run off 6 straight points. LSU by 7 as we approach the midpoint of the first half. T.J. Pugh has checked in at point guard. O'Neal's pass a few behind him. And a backcourt violation against LSU. Just the second turnover committed by the Tigers. Nover in the paint, had to get out to avoid a 3-second violation, then turned it over to Pugh. Singleton off to O'Neal. O'Neal lost it. Stripped by Jamal Meeks.
Jamal Meeks continues to play great basketball for Indiana. O'Neal usually very patient underneath the basket, that time a little too quick.
Nover scores. That's 8 straight points for Indiana. The 14-point lead is down to 5. Nine straight points make it for Indiana. Caesar stops that run with a 3-pointer. 10 points for the freshman, Clarence Caesar. Eric Anderson open for 3. Got it. Where has that been for Indiana? Anderson came into this one having made only 2 3-point field goals in the last 13 games.
Indiana has great spot-up shooters, but LSU's zone defense is giving them that opportunity. A man-to-man defense against Indiana will force them to create offensively. Chaney, the only really skilled player at that type of game.
Meeks off to Anderson, wide open again. Does Dale Brown need a timeout? The momentum has clearly turned to IU. He's going to get one in 15 seconds with a TV timeout.
LSU has to stay composed here, not get frustrated by the fact that they're missing some shots right now.
Williamson continues to sizzle. 8 points for Maurice Williamson. And a ball came out of the stands. That's the reason for the whistle. The lead is 6 for LSU with 8 minutes to play in the first half. Indiana on a 14-5 run over the last 406 rather. They've hit their last 6 shots. Damon Bailey has returned. Bailey, Meeks, Chaney, Anderson, and Henderson for Indiana. This is Henderson. He played 2 strong games in the tournament for IU. 4 points for the freshman, Allen Henderson.
LSU's defense is giving Indiana's big men too many easy 15, 18-foot spot-up jumpers. O'Neal's got to come out of the perimeter defensively.
Air ball from three-point land and sees it. And there's the timeout that Dale Fuller and Dale Brown have been looking forward to. 33-29, LSU.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
An offensive start to this battle between LSU and Indiana. The Tigers shooting 64% from the floor, Indiana 62%. And it's a four-point lead for LSU. The Tigers led by as many as 14 points, 27-13. Jamal Meeks has provided a spark off the bench. As is Anderson, he is slapped away by Caesar. Bailey, Meeks, Henderson, Cheney, and Anderson, the five from Bob Knight. Henderson. He's demonstrated in the two games he can make that shot. It might be a good idea to get out and play him. As you've been saying.
That's the problem with the zone defense. When you have a big man like O'Neal, play man-to-man, force them to come to the basket and knock layups. If you let them spot up on the baseline where the openings always are against the zone defense, Indiana can have a great chance to win this game.
Foul was on Allen Henderson, his first, and the fourth against Indiana here in the first half. Singleton to Williamson on the floor with Brandon, Caesar, and O'Neal for LSU. Singleton called for a charge as he slams into Calvert Cheney. 33-31 LSU. Let's check in with Jim Nance.
Thanks, Sean. The story in the Midwest has been Georgia Tech, and it's shooting from the floor, leading 20-13 with 11:30 to go in the first half. Tech now adding another basket to lead 22-13, Mike.
Travis Best off quickly for Tech. They hit four from three, Billy, and really they've done a tremendous job and red hot from the start.
It looks like John Berry is the guy that's being matched up with Meyer. Berry has shown this year he's a very tenacious player. And you know what? When he gets occupied defensively, he seems to play better on the offensive end of the floor as well. There he is with an excellent rebound.
Mike, you call this a pivotal game for the Pac-10. As we now go back over to LSU and Indiana.
The reason being, Arizona's out. They had a 1-2 and a 3 seed, and the Pac-10 wanted to prove in this conference this year that their conference is one of the best in the country.
Billy, as soon as Shaquille O'Neal went to the bench with that 14-point lead, you said this is not a good idea.
No, I didn't think it was a good idea at all. I remember back in 1981 in Philadelphia, LSU had Indiana on the ropes in the first half of that game. Isaiah Thomas had to sit down with some foul trouble. Ethan Martin, who was playing great, Dale Brown put him on the bench as well. I did not think it was a good move by Dale Brown. When you've got that kind of momentum, you're going for the knockout punch, you have to do it right then and there. And now what you see is Indiana back in the basketball game, restored their confidence, and now it becomes a dogfight all over again.
All right, Sean and Bill, back to you.
Thank you, gentlemen. Bill Walton made that point as soon as Shaquille O'Neal went to the bench. And that raises the larger question, which has been much discussed here in Boise this week. Is Dale Brown a good coach? We'll get into that as time allows. Calvert Cheney with two free throws to tie it up. So they come all the way back from the 14-point deficit. It's 33 all with 6 minutes to play in the first half. O'Neal had it poked away by Anderson.
Not a good idea to throw that pass. O'Neal, no room to operate inside.
Indiana looking for its first lead of the game. Calvert Cheney nearly lost at the fall. Marshall, number 25, the freshman who's come on for LSU.
You can just see the confidence level surging in Indiana.
Cheney followed his own three-point miss. Blocked by O'Neal, number four. Out of bounds, it will be Indiana ball.
On the baseline for Cheney, O'Neal off the board, tries to garner the rebound. Excellent effort.
Henderson, fouled by Caesar. Two fouls on Clarence Caesar.
Now number 22, Clarence Caesar, second personal.
Why high foul down low when a man is within 8 or 10 feet of the basket. O'Neal's going to intimidate every one of those shots. Know who's out on the court. Know that all you have to do is force your man closer to the basket.
Hugh and Marshall go to the bench. Dale Brown is the new backcourt, the starting backcourt back out there of Williamson and Brandon. Henderson got it to roll in, and Indiana leads for the first time of the game, 34-33, with 5:10 to play in the half. Henderson coming off his 17-point performance on Thursday night against Eastern Illinois. He had a team-high 11 rebounds, 3 blocks, and 3 steals in that one. Whistle away from the ball. It's against Eric Anderson, his first.
That kind of play will happen a lot against Indiana tonight. That's not a bad foul. They've got two guys. O'Neal fighting to get across the lane. Anderson in his path. Not much contact there. Might see him let that go a little bit.
O'Neal nicely off. Just came in. Brandon knocked down Graham on the rebound activity without a whistle, and Anderson cleared up the miss. Graham to Meeks, and now Bailey. Anderson and Henderson also out there for Indiana. Henderson does not miss from that spot. 10 points for Allen Henderson.
You'd think by now they would realize that guy and Eric Anderson are going to make those shots. You've got to stay with them.
O'Neal knocks down Anderson and gets called for the foul. 2 fouls on Shaquille O'Neal. That will bring Gert Hamick back into the game, and O'Neal will take a seat. Shaquille heads to the bench with 7 points, 4 block shots, and 3 rebounds. Both teams continuing to shoot well. There's Hamick, the 7-footer from the Netherlands. Anderson now with 6.
Give Eric Anderson lots of credit. Physically outsized against O'Neal. He's in there, he's battling, he's fighting, giving everything he can, even though O'Neal has got so much more strength. Anderson's going to give it everything he has today. It may not be enough. He's going to at least give it his shot.
Indiana, a perfect 6-for-6 from the line. Their lead is 6. You're just tuning in. It was once 27-13 LSU. After the 3-pointer by Maurice Williamson, it's now 39-36 Indiana, under 4 minutes to play in the first half here in Boise. The winner meets Florida State in the Sweet 16 in Albuquerque. Meek, nice bounce pass. Henderson scores.
Outstanding offensive execution against the zone defense.
Meeks has been terrific since he came in. Brandon didn't get the bounce. And a foul against Harold Boudreau as he knocked down Calvert Cheney. First foul on Boudreau, the senior from Arnoldville, Louisiana. His brother is still in the tournament. His twin brother, Carol, is a member of the Ragin' Cajuns of southwestern Louisiana. Carol plays for LSU, and Carol plays for USL. We'll see USL on Cinderella Sunday tomorrow. Matt Nober back in. A nice hand for Eric Anderson as he departs with 7 points.
LSU's offense appears to have fallen apart right now. They're taking every shot basically off the dribble with an Indiana player right in their face. They're missing. Indiana's in great position for the rebound. They're able to control the tempo.
11 points for Calvert Cheney. Indiana's lead is now 7.
Back in in Boise, Andrea Joyce, along with Florida State coach Pat Kennedy, who's getting ready to head to Albuquerque after defeating Georgetown in the first game. You've had a chance to catch your breath now. You got these two teams out here today, Indiana and LSU. You're going to face one of them next week. What do you think?
Well, we played Indiana last year in the second round, and they're playing today like a team with a mission. They're just playing great on the offensive end. They're doing a good job of holding Shaquille down. Of course, LSU, when you play them, Shaquille is the person you got
to
stop.
You're going to go right to Albuquerque. Your injured point guard, Charlie Ward, is going to go home with his dislocated shoulder, have an MRI. Is there any chance that we might see him again in the tournament?
Yes, there is, Andrew. When he gets checked out in Tallahassee, we're going to fly him back out to Albuquerque. Charlie wants to do this whether he's playing or not. He was an inspiration today. The kids won this one for Charlie.
All right, thanks very much. Good luck next week. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Andrea. And Coach Kennedy's team has proven that they can win games without their key people. In their first ACC game ever, they went up to North Carolina and won in Chapel Hill without their leading scorer from a year ago, Douglas Edwards, and without Ray Donald, both serving a one-game suspension for fighting. They went to NC State and won a game there without Chuck Graham and Rodney Dobart. Today, they won without Charlie Ward. The bucket by Shaquille O'Neal gives him 9 points for the game. The Indiana lead is five. The rebound of the Cheney miss down in the arms of Jamie Brandon. The sophomore point guard from Chicago off to Justin Anderson. He's instant offense ordinarily off the bench, missing his first try of the game.
LSU is really struggling offensively. Nothing happening. Trying to force the ball into O'Neal. Indiana's collapsing down around him. Poor post feeding, poor decision making. They're down five.
Brandon missed a three. It came out to Williamson. Anderson. Nover control. Indiana 43, LSU 38 with a minute 20 to play in the half. The crowd thought Nover traveled, as did Dale Brown. As did Sean McDonough. Cheney scores over O'Neal with a high arcing jumper, 13 for Calvert Cheney.
Indiana has total control of this game right now. LSU's zone defense, I think, is feeding into Indiana's skills, which is teamwork, ball movement. And LSU's poor offense is allowing Indiana to sag around O'Neal, not letting him get the ball.
Now Indiana spreads the floor. There's about a 4 or 5 second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Brandon, with time, 6 seconds left in the half. We raised the question moments ago about Dale Brown. Is he a good coach? Yesterday at his press conference, Bobby Knight blasted the national media, saying it was their fault that there is a sense around the country that Dale Brown is not a good coach. Quite a turnaround for Bobby Knight, considering in 1987, after Indiana's win against LSU, he uttered the quote you just saw. Welcome. Cheney misses a long three at the buzzer. After Indiana came from behind to beat LSU in the tournament in 87, Bobby Knight said, "I was afraid of losing until I saw Dale Brown at the other end of the floor. Then I knew we had a chance." That's the end of the first half with the score Indiana 45 and LSU 38. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the second round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Chevrolet, the cars and trucks more people depend on. ITT Corporation, building people's dreams. And by cold-filtered Keystone, Keystone Light, and Keystone Dry.
At one time, LSU led 27-13. The rest of the half, Indiana 32-11. Jim Nance, Billy Packer, Mike Francesa in New York. Mike, what about that half?
Do we have an indication yet of who the blowout is?
I thought the blowout was there. I thought I had made my mark. And I felt that one or the other team was going to start this game because of Shaquille O'Neal, either play their style, being in the case of LSU, and blow out Indiana, or Indiana would be able to compensate and come back. And it still may be that way.
Let's touch on something, though. 11:50 left first half. 27-13 lead for LSU. They really have Indiana on the ropes. He sits Shaquille O'Neal down. I didn't understand why. You understand why?
No, I don't understand why Dale took him out either. And again, I go back to that 81 game. It would be the kind of thing that would be flashing in your mind. There was a situation LSU, I thought, had an opportunity to knock out that outstanding IU team that eventually won a national championship. Isaiah sits down. Ethan Martin sits down. Ethan was the guy in control of that game that particular day. I thought Shaquille was in control of this one.
And Indiana did a great job, Jim, of dissecting the LSU defense and really getting nice, easy shots on the baseline and on the wing and real easy shots time after time down the floor.
Eric Anderson hitting those jumpers from the side is something that IU, I'm sure, wanted to see. They've been waiting for him to start getting his shot back.
Indiana turned it around like Ohio State did against UConn this afternoon. Let's set the lineup for tomorrow. Triple header action coming your way. Whole bunch of Cinderellas will be in action. Tulane and Oklahoma State, or Michigan State, Cincinnati. When we come on the air at 12 noon Eastern, the tip will follow shortly thereafter. And then four games at once in the middle of the day. Some will see East Tennessee State against the Fab Five, the freshmen of Michigan. Others will watch UTEP against the one seed Kansas, Iowa State against Kentucky, Southwestern Louisiana, the Raging Cajuns against New Mexico State. That's the real battle of Cinderellas. And then late, somewhere around 4:45, we expect the tip times for Louisville against UCLA and Syracuse against Massachusetts in the East. Now, 2:50 to go in the half at Milwaukee. Georgia Tech's lead over USC is 4. And let's check in on that game right now with Dick Stockton and Al McGuire.
Here in Milwaukee, Minneapolisville will have the championship. This is just the first two rounds. Dick Stockton and Al McGuire. Georgia Tech had a 12-point lead. Forrest makes the first free throw for Tech. Gives him a 5-point lead. Harold Miner, the big story of this game, big scorer in the country, has only 2 points. He's on the bench. All things have gone wrong for USC, right for Georgia Tech, and yet it's a close game, Al.
Tight ball game. I think you see Harold Miner back in before halftime. There's just a little bit under 3 minutes left. Anybody's ball game. I think Coach Raff should be very pleased with the setup this time, especially with Georgia Tech hitting 5 from touchdown land and Harold Miner on the trap.
John Barry has hit 3, and Travis Best 2 3-point baskets, and he had a 36-31. USC, the number 2 seed, with the ball is Wayne Cooper. Hackett misses a 3, gets the ball back. 2.5 remaining in the first half.
George just went to Miner to put him back in.
Gambling for the steal is James Forrest. And open with plenty of time is Hackett, and he hits the 3. Good passing. They didn't get into the corner quick enough, and it's now a 36-34 game with Miner coming back in momentarily.
He was recruited as a shooter. He proved it right there.
Each team has 5 3-point baskets thus far. Matt Geiger, the big 7-footer, misses. Can't be saved, so SC will have the ball, and Miner, Harold Miner, averaging 27 a game back in. Travis Best, his return to the game, the freshman point guard. Geiger goes out.
What they got to do right here, Dick, they got to get H to get a basket so he doesn't go in there at halftime and psych himself out for the second half. H, Harold Miner, let's call him H, that's his nickname.
Another 3 for Hackett, that's 4 threes. For the last 12 USC points, and the Trojans lead it 37-36, their first lead since 2-0.
Georgia Tech is not extending their defense. That's how come dropping down those threes.
Best. And Yamin Sanders with the rebound, stolen. No look pass by Barry, and a lay-in by Malcolm Mackey. And Barry can.
Hey, 1:15 to go in the half, and Mike and Billy, we'll get back to the finish of this game after LSU and Indiana concludes.
The feeling I have on this game is Georgia Tech shot the lights out, 14-19, 15-20 now. Miner, 0-5, has 2 points. and they're winning the game by a couple of points. USC's moved now ahead. You can't be happy if you're Georgia Tech.
You know, Mike, it's the kind of thing that coaches go in the locker room, the head coach gets his assistants around, and they start looking at that stat sheet, and that one starts shaking right out of your hands. You say, my gosh, how can we
be
this close? Exactly. Yeah. We can't play any better on one end of the floor. They can't play any worse, and we're only up one.
Yep.
Well, these scores are shaking right out of my hand right now. Okay, let's
do
get through them one more time. If you just joined us, Seton Hall over Missouri by 17. Next for the Pirates will be Duke, 13-point winners over Iowa. They will meet in Philadelphia on Thursday. Florida State over Georgetown. Alonzo Mourning fouled out with 2 minutes to go. And Doug Edwards had 15 points, 16 rebounds. Charlie Ward did not play, the starting point guard for Florida State. That's Doug Edwards on the alley-oop slam. Irvin Church with a three for Georgetown. Second half, Florida State, Sam Cassell hits the three-pointer that puts them up six. This was the big basket, Mike.
No question about it. They battled back. One's Alonzo Mourning, who you see right there, fouled out his last game. Never got to the Final Four. That was the end of it. They went on a huge run, 17-4, as you said, to close the game out. And a big win for Florida State.
I think excellent coaching game by Pat Kennedy. He talked about he started out with an odd defense, a diamond in one on Alonzo to hold him down. But instead, it took away from his offense. Changed his defensive structure in the second half. Very good bench coaching job on the part of Pat Kennedy to go ahead and help his team go on to that win.
Well, we saw USC and Georgia Tech very close, maybe headed for a last-second finish. That was the case with the first game there today. Arkansas, the three seed, is out of the tournament. Memphis State, with David Vaughn's 26 points, the game winner with 6 seconds to go, and the Tigers, a sixth seed, advanced to the Sweet 16. Alabama and North Carolina, the Tar Heels, 12 straight years now into the regionals with that victory today, and Ohio State will be the next opponent for Dean Smith, a 78-55 victory over UConn as Jimmy Jackson had 18 points in the second half of that game for the Buckeyes. We'll continue on the road to the Final Four right after this.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the second round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Oldsmobile, official car for NCAA championships. UPS, offering 10:30 guaranteed overnight air delivery. And by Budweiser, the king of beers with a clean, crisp, cold taste. Nothing beats a Bud.
Welcome back to Boise. We're at the half. Indiana enjoys a 7-point lead over LSU. Sean McDonough with Bill Walton. We raised the question of Dale Brown's coaching ability just before halftime. We'll discuss that issue in a matter of moments, but the teams are ready to go here in the second half. LSU with the ball. Jamie Brandon and Maurice Williamson open the half in the backcourt. O'Neal, Singleton, and Caesar, the starting front court, also on the floor. For those of you just joining us, welcome to Boise, where Shaquille O'Neal has just scored the first points of the second half. For the LSU Tigers, clad in gold, Sean McDonough with Bill Walton. Happy to have you with us for second round action in the West region. The winner of this one meets Florida State in the Sweet 16. LSU got off to a torrid start, ran off to a 14-point lead. Then Indiana dominated the second half of the first half. O'Neal changed the shot of Madden over. And here comes LSU with a chance to cut into the 5-point deficit.
LSU played very well off the start. Getting the ball back into O'Neal. He's using his superior strength and power and balance to get easy shooting opportunities.
Second foul on Nover. O'Neal now with 13 points.
One of the few times O'Neal has been able to get free. No contact coming across the floor.
Shaquille O'Neal, the SEC Player of the Year for the second consecutive year. Now with 14 points. That's 4 years in a row that LSU has had the SEC Player of the Year, as Chris Jackson won that honor in 89 and 90. First time in SEC history that one school has had the Player of the Year 4 years in a row. Jamal Meeks, he provided the spark off the bench for Indiana in the first half. He opens the second half with Bailey, Cheney, Nover, and Henderson. Cheney scores around O'Neal. 15 points for Calvert Cheney.
O'Neal has not been the same player since Dale Brown took him out after the phenomenal start. Bob Knight sensing that Jamal Meeks playing great left Meeks in the game.
And Meeks just committed a foul. Let's check in with Andrea Joyce.
Guys, Maurice Williamson came out of the locker room limping. He apparently has a bruise below his left knee, and he got it Thursday against BYU. He aggravated it at the end of the first half. They iced it at halftime, and we'll see how he does.
O'Neal with the line. Only a 50% free throw shooter for the year. If he has a weakness, that's it.
That was always Chamberlain's weakness, too. That's why O'Neal needs to develop that perimeter shot facing the basket. It will cut down on the number of fouls that he absorbs.
You made the point. And it's a good one, Bill. LSU, to start the half, has gone right back to its strength in Shaquille O'Neal. Nova, much too strong. O'Neal ripped down the rebound and hit the floor, but kept the dribble alive to Jamie Brandon. Williamson, right back to O'Neal. Over Nova. 18 for Shaquille. 9 in the first 2 minutes of the second half, and we're tied again at 47. Bailey, those are Damon's first points of the game.
LSU's zone defense feeds right into Indiana's strength, which is ball movement, interior passing, and spot-up shooting. A man-to-man defense, I think, will take Indiana out of this game. With O'Neal behind you to back up your penetration or your perimeter defense.
Henderson created the steal at the other end. Now Cheney to Henderson. Cheney fouled. And he'll go to the line to shoot two. Clarence Caesar committed the foul. That's his third. Cinderella Sunday begins tomorrow at noon Eastern time with Tulane. An upset win over St. John's in the first round against Oklahoma State. Michigan State over Cincinnati. Weren't the Bearcats impressive in round one against Delaware? Caesar to the bench with his three fouls. He's been replaced by Justin Anderson. Indiana, a perfect 9 for 9 from the free throw line now. We played 3 minutes in the second half. Indiana led by 7 at the break. They've scored a 5-point lead now. Singleton. Rebounded by Meeks.
Collapsing defense. Forcing those shots from the perimeter by LSU.
Foul on the rebound. It's against Allen Henderson. Coach Knight showing emotion for one of the few times to this point. T.J. Pugh back in the lineup for LSU, replacing Jamie Brandon.
Dale Brown trying to find some exterior offense.
Pugh, ordinarily reluctant to shoot. That time he fired up a three just off the bench, and it was well short. Short, rebounded by O'Neal. LSU with the ball trailing by 5 as we approach 4 minutes played here in the second half. Justin Anderson with a three-pointer. He's a senior from Valley City, North Dakota. His father was a college teammate of Dale Brown. Anderson transferred into LSU after 3 seasons at Cal Irvine. And a turnover. Cheney tried to hit Meeks and missed him. 15-51 to play in Boise. It's Indiana by 2.
NCAA Division II Basketball Championship next Saturday on CBS Sports.
The second seed in the West, Indiana, with a two-point lead over the number seven seed, LSU, with 15:51 to play in the second half here. Tom McDonald with Bill Walton, LSU with the ball, DJU. Now in the backcourt with Maurice Williamson, O'Neal, Singleton, and Anderson, the front court for Dale Brown.
Not a single player in Indiana out above the foul line.
Williamson didn't get it to drop. Anderson pulled it down. This is Damon Bailey with Meek, Chaney, Anderson, and Henderson for Indiana. Bounced it down low, but Singleton got in the way. Williamson on the move. The layup. Bailey was the defender.
One of the few times today that LSU's been able to get into transition. Give a lot of credit to Indiana's set offense for keeping LSU on their heels.
And another turnover by Indiana. That has Bobby Knight looking for a substitute. It'll be Chris Reynolds. Williamson off the mark again. Singleton the offensive rebound, and he traveled. As he struggled to clear the ball from three Indiana defenders, he shuffled his feet. 11 turnovers committed by LSU. Dale Brown has the Tigers in the postseason for the 14th straight year. The last 9 years they've been in the NCAA tournament. Chaney kicked it out to Anderson. That's three. And 10 points in all for Eric Anderson, the senior from Chicago.
That area of the court between the foul line and about 6 feet away from the basket, that's so wide open in the zone, that's creating all the offense for Indiana that they're going to need.
O'Neal. Whistle. And a foul called on Allen Henderson. Three fouls now on Henderson. Henderson, a highly recruited player and also an excellent student. He scored 1,300 on the SATs. And he's a pre-med major at IU. They don't start to O'Neal. Count the bucket. And Shaquille will go to the line with a chance to bring the Tigers within two.
O'Neal showing some excellent shooting range here in the low post. Little soft pass there. Indiana continues to play behind. Nice little kiss off the glass there by O'Neal.
Shaq up to 20 points. He averages just under 24 a game. He had 26 in the opening round win over BYU. It's back to a two-point Indiana lead as we tick down toward 14 minutes remaining here in Boise. Chris Reynolds back in action for Indiana. Chaney. Blocked by O'Neal. Number five. Hugh kicks it out. O'Neal. Line drive at home. Henderson rebounded the miss. Six rebounds for Allen Henderson.
When you're as big as O'Neal is and jumps so well, you're almost looking down at the basket. He's got to learn to put a little bit of arch on it.
Chaney lobbed it in over O'Neal. 19 for Calvert Chaney. O'Neal short as he tried to score over Anderson. Anderson lost the feed from Reynolds.
O'Neal in the lane against Chaney. Tapping it out, igniting the transition offense. O'Neal has, I think, a bad habit of allowing the players to receive the ball in there. Chaney, even though that one was blocked, has had the edge a number of times today.
O'Neal obviously winded on the bench. Hammock is back in, as is Mike Hansen with the ball now, number 11 for LSU. crashes into Anderson. It's an offensive foul. Three fouls on Maurice Williamson. Shaquille O'Neal helping to keep LSU close with 21 points. Five block shots, giving him 16 in the two games of the tournament. Almost all of Indiana's production coming from the front court. 51 of their 57 points. Drake Graham for Reynolds. They comprise the Indiana backcourt at the moment with Cheney, Henderson, and Anderson, the front three. Henderson scores over Hammond. 14 for Allen Henderson.
Indiana continues to do the same thing over and over. Get the ball into the foul line area, the collapsing zone, and guys wide open with great interior passing along the baseline.
Hammond, short, ripped down by Cheney. Reynolds. And now Graham settles. Greg Graham is yet to score in this one for Indiana. The Hoosiers lead by six. They were up seven at the half. We're inside of 12 minutes to play. Cheney. Hammock the rebound. This is Hanson. Underneath Singleton. What an acrobatic play.
Transition offense for LSU. Without that, they're totally out of this game because their set offense has been strictly Shaquille O'Neal since Caesar was hot off the opening tap.
O'Neal waiting to check back in. Reynolds has it back from Anderson. Reynolds doesn't pull the trigger very often. He moves by Williamson. Cheney scores. Williamson actually got a hand on the ball, but unfortunately for LSU, he batted it right to Cheney. The lead is six for Indiana.
And when is LSU going to change their defense?
Foul call. Anderson was leaning on Hammond. We have a timeout here in Boise. O'Neal will return with his team trailing by six. Nearly midway through the second half, Indiana with a six-point lead over LSU. Mike Hanson inbounds for the Tigers. This is Singleton and now Justin Anderson. Williamson and O'Neal also on the floor for LSU. Hanson. Rebounded by Meeks.
Nover doing an excellent job of keeping O'Neal off the offensive glass. Great position.
Reynolds, nice pass. Cheney scores with an acrobatic play around O'Neal. 23 for Calvert Cheney. O'Neal knocked to the deck. O'Neal will join the line. We're at Boise State Pavilion. A beautiful arena of 12,000 on the campus of Boise State University in the capital city of Idaho. This is second round action in the West region. And there's a timeout on the floor with 10-11 to play in the second half. Indiana 63 and LSU 55. We'll be back in just a moment.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Welcome back to Boise. Indiana with an eight-point lead. 10-11 to play. Dale Brown just used one of his timeouts. And now Shaquille O'Neal at the line. Shaquille with 22 points. He had nine at halftime. And he's perfect from the free throw line. 7 for 7. The lob, stolen by O'Neal. Meeks tried to lob it in behind O'Neal to Henderson. Not a good idea. Williamson's pass knocked out of bounds. So it's a six-point game, Indiana on top. And we're past the midway point of the second half.
If that lob pass is going to work to Henderson, which was open, you're going to have to come and set a back screen on O'Neal to keep him from dropping back and intercepting that pass at its peak.
Mike Hansen, Maurice Williamson, they are the backcourt for LSU. Hansen, the junior from Madrid, Spain, that's Caesar. He's had a quiet day. Singleton kept it alive for O'Neal. He is surrounded, too strong off the glass. The rebound hit the floor. Meeks. Tommy Knight using a backcourt of two players who are ordinarily point guard. Nolan fouled by O'Neal. Three personals now for Shaquille. With 9:22 to play. Played a long time without picking up the foul. The second foul came at 4:13 remaining in the first half.
Penetration. That's an offensive foul, in my opinion. O'Neal vertically in the air. Nover wipes him off with the off arm.
Points from Matt Nover, responding to the challenge of playing against O'Neal. He ordinarily averages 6 points per game. Just joining us once again, welcome back to Boise, where Matt Nover has just made one of two free throws for Indiana, and the Hoosiers have a 7-point lead. That was their advantage at halftime. Now we're down to 9:07 to play. O'Neal scores again. 25 points for Shaquille O'Neal, 16 of them here in the second half.
Even that time, it was effective for LSU down low. That post pass has got to be harder. O'Neal waiting for it on his heels.
Meeks, to Bailey, Nover, Cheney, and Henderson. Also on the floor for Indiana. Henderson scores. 16 for Allen Henderson, the all-time leading scorer in Indianapolis high school basketball history, passing the likes of Oscar Robertson and Eric Montross. O'Neal. That one spit out. Pulled in by Cheney. Well, they're getting the ball to Shaquille relatively easily.
I'm very surprised that they're not playing in front of O'Neal, forcing the lob, getting weak side help.
Henderson is fouled.
Look at the intensity on Allen Henderson's face. He is so fired up. He senses that he's on a roll. He's been hitting from the baseline all day long. LSU's defense has not responded. They've not changed at all today. They've stuck with the game plan. No adaptations for LSU at all.
Points in the game and 6 rebounds for Henderson. The lead is 10 for Indiana. That is the Hoosiers' largest lead as we tick down to 8 minutes remaining. The winner of this one meets Florida State. Singleton. That's a 2-point field goal. And 12 in the game for Vernell Singleton.
Look how Indiana's mixing up their defense. Half-court pressure one time, next time drop it down. Once you become predictable, you're very easy to beat.
Meeks nearly lost the dribble. Henderson looking for somebody. He finds Bailey. A tip by Henderson, the rebound by O'Neal. Singleton to T.J. Pugh. Maurice Williamson still in the game for LSU, playing with 4 fouls. Caesar from the foul line, tracked down by Cheney. Less than 7 minutes to play. Indiana with an 8-point lead. The Hoosiers looking for their 25th win of the year. They're 24-6. Cheney. He has not been affected one bit by the presence in this game of Shaquille O'Neal.
Most of the players that play against O'Neal are so intimidated by him. They've never played against someone with that type of physical ability. Chaney, on the other hand, has gone so strong right at O'Neal all day long. And that area between the foul line and 8 feet from the basket, totally dominated by Indiana today. LSU has not responded.
O'Neal scored. He was fouled by Matt Dover. That's three fouls on Dover. Light with a word for Damon Bailey. Shaquille looking for his 28th point. He's 8 for 8 from the line. You mentioned Thursday night, he makes the free throws when they matter. They matter in this game. Ordinarily a 50% free throw shooter, a perfect 100% tonight. Jamie Brandon back in for the Tigers. P.J. Pugh back on the bench with 6:18 to play and with Indiana leading by 7.
Different strategies by the different coaches, Knight and Brown. Lots of players into the action for LSU, very few for Indiana. Stick with the guys who are playing well.
Singleton down the lane, count the basket. Fouled by Damon Bailey. Three fouls on Bailey. That is the 9th foul committed by Indiana in this half. LSU has only committed 4. Indiana won't be in a bonus shooting situation for a while. Caesar had it, then was stripped by Jamal Meeks. Indiana by 5, under 6 minutes to play. Nober. What a game Matt Nober is having for Indiana. 13 points for the junior from Chesterton, Indiana. Bobby Knight said last year during the NCAA tournament that Nober sometimes has an anxiety about playing offense. No anxiety demonstrated today.
One thing I've learned from playing years of basketball, you don't wait for good players to start missing shots. You've got to change your strategy to force them into different patterns.
That again raises the question about Dale Brown. I showed you the quote just before halftime by Bobby Knight. After Indiana's win, how about that rebound for Shaquille? In 1987 in the tournament over LSU, when the team was down by a dozen, he said, "I was afraid of losing, but I saw Dale Brown on the other bench, and I knew we had a chance." Caesar hoping LSU still has a chance. He drove in a 3. The margin is 5. Under 5 minutes to play. You've worked with LSU and with Shaquille O'Neal in particular, but you've been around Dale Brown a lot. Bobby Knight has since recanted, says he thinks Dale Brown is a fine coach and his record speaks for itself.
I agree with that, but I would never take a top player out who's dominating the game at that time. O'Neal was not in foul trouble. That decision, I thought, was a poor one, plus the decision to stay with his own defense when you have a great shot blocker behind you.
Henderson, rare miss from that spot, and Chaney hacked O'Neal after he pulled down the rebound. You sense that the momentum is shifting a little bit here to LSU.
The 5-point spread, certainly LSU is right in it, but nothing has really changed in terms of strategy. I feel when you have a great big man shot blocker like O'Neal, like Mourning in the previous game today, you play man-to-man pressure defense. That cuts down the opportunities that the offense has. They've got to then beat the man on the perimeter, and then all of a sudden they're at the hoop, and that's where the big shot blocker is.
And it goes back to the point that I made right at the top of the telecast, quoting Dale Brown from practice yesterday. The key is to switch defenses to keep Indiana out of a half-court offensive rhythm. I mean, they haven't really switched those defenses at all, and Indiana has been in a rhythm. 73 points on the board for the Hoosiers with 4 minutes to play, but the free throws by O'Neal, who now has 30 points. And it's LSU within 3. Cooley running some time down. Dale Brown pointing out correctly so that the shot clock shows 40 seconds. He came running all the way down to midcourt and started slamming on the table. No, there aren't any telephones over there that we can see at least. And now the old and once again new friends talking things over. There definitely was a problem with the 45-second clock. And as they sort it out, we'll take a break. LSU within three here in Boise. Welcome back to Boise, where Shaquille O'Neal is almost single-handedly bringing LSU back. And each team has missed only one free throw in this one. Indiana with the ball and a three-point lead. With 3:35 to play, they reset the shot clock at 22 seconds out of the timeout. It now shows 13. Bailey fires with 7 on the clock and drained a long three. Only 6 points in the game for Damon Bailey on 2 3-pointers.
Indiana's defense not even challenging LSU on the perimeter. It's allowing them to shoot. LSU too reluctant. They've got to create. O'Neal can't do everything.
Although he's doing his best to do just that. 32 points for O'Neal. 23 of them in the second half. Indiana by 4 with 2:45 remaining. Cheney. Whistle. Foul. Count the bucket. The foul was on Vernell Singleton. His 4th.
When you allow a creative offensive player to get the ball that easily, doesn't matter what the defense does, even if you're as great as O'Neal. In all my years of playing against the best player I ever played against, Abdul-Jabbar, all I tried to do was deny position and possession. You cannot get in the air and contest great players once they've got their momentum to the basket.
Caesar for 3. Foul on the rebound. That's on Vernell Singleton. And he is fouled out. And LSU calls timeout. That leaves the Tigers with just one timeout remaining. We'll be back in just a moment. LSU now with one timeout remaining. The possession arrow points to Indiana. The scoreboard also favors Indiana. 79-72 the score with 2:34 to play. Jamal Meeks guarded tightly in the man-to-man by Williamson. They have switched the defense to man-to-man. They can't afford to let Indiana run time off the clock. Anderson drives up Caesar. Now Cheney, guarded by Brandon. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Anderson fouled by Caesar. 4 fouls on Clarence Caesar. One of the features of this West Regional, the 2 big men, Alonzo Mourning and Shaquille O'Neal. Mourning and the Hoyas of Georgetown already knocked out of the tournament today here in Boise by Florida State. And Shaquille O'Neal is moving dangerously close to elimination himself. This could be his final college game. He said he'll make the decision about whether to go to the NBA when the season is over.
And very similar games to these 2 great big men, Mourning and O'Neal, carrying their teams. The teams, I think, unconsciously are allowing their big key players to carry too much of the load. Everybody has to play, and it's the coach's responsibility to get guys to surround O'Neal, who can fill it up from the perimeter to open up the game inside for him.
Indiana with a 9-point lead under 2 minutes to play, and Anderson fouls Bailey in the backcourt. Number 9, Justin Anderson. Bailey makes the first. Indiana 16 of 17 from the line. Damon was a bit of a prophet yesterday himself when he said Indiana needed to be more patient on offense, set better screens. That would create jump shots that were open. And they could score, and they've done that nicely.
One player in particular who's done that beautifully has been Matt Nover. Lots of back screens on O'Neal, freeing up Cheney, Henderson. Wonderful game, Matt Nover.
Indiana with the ball, an 11-point lead. They are eyeing a rematch in the tournament with Florida State. They knocked out the Seminoles in the second round last year in Louisville. Holding the call against Williamson. He has fouled out. With a minute 13 to play. 11 points in this one for Williamson. 41 points in the two games in the tournament for Williamson.
You talked, Sean, about the necessity for someone on LSU other than O'Neal to have a big game. Mm-hmm. You really need that when you have a dominant big man. The floor has to be spread. The first game of this tournament, it was Mo Williamson. Big night offensively. Tonight, no one other than O'Neal.
You saw the numbers for Shaquille. Certainly, he has done all that he can do. You think he should return to college basketball?
Most definitely.
Foul on the rebound, Anderson went over the back of Shaquille O'Neal.
Bill Brown said yesterday, let's not take this young man's youth away from him.
Mm-hmm.
He has a tremendous future ahead of him in this wonderful game of basketball. One more year of college basketball will help him develop emotionally, psychologically. And hey, let's face it, college is fun. College basketball is great.
I would think Shaquille will be back, since he has said that money doesn't mean anything to him. He said you can't miss what you've never had. And if that's the case, you say, why not stay in college, continue to hone your skills? And it might be a slightly empty feeling in terms of accomplishment here at the college level. Although he has been a dominant player individually, his team, in the scope of things, has not accomplished a lot. A minute and 11 seconds to play here in Boise. Welcome back to Boise in the Midwest region of Milwaukee. Georgia Tech trying to eliminate the second-seeded USC Trojans with a five-point lead. As soon as this one is over, we'll send you to the Bradley Center for the conclusion of that game. We're here at Boise State Pavilion in Boise, Idaho, hosting NCAA tournament action for the third time, and the tournament returns to this building in 1995. We commend all of the people here in Boise. They've done a wonderful job this week in every facet of hosting the NCAA tournament. Bob Knight and the Hoosiers with a 10-point lead, and Clarence Caesar fouls out.
You're so right that the people of Boise did a great job. Don't overlook the great job that Bob Knight did in today's game.
Mm-hmm.
This team, Indiana, was, I think, psychologically decimated at the start of the game when O'Neal was dominating, blocking shots, dunking the basketball. He brought them back. He makes his players believe in themselves. They've come out and dominated the flow of this game ever since that man, Shaquille O'Neal, went to the bench with what I think was a poor substitution midway through the first half.
Greg Graham made the first one. That is Dale Brown's grandson, Christopher. One. 12-point lead for Indiana. This is the largest lead enjoyed by the Hoosiers. And they are a minute away from a trip to Albuquerque. Anderson the middle. O'Neal with 36 points. 12 rebounds. And 5 block shots.
Number 5, Justin Anderson, second free throw.
And those numbers you just heard for Shaquille O'Neal add up to Chevrolet Player of the Game honors. DJ Pugh. Now Paul Marshall, the freshman. John Piku just checked in for the first time of the tournament, gets it alive and kicks it out to Hansen. And a foul called against Harold Boudreau. We mentioned that Shaquille O'Neal is the Chevrolet Player of the Game for LSU. And for Indiana, our Chevrolet Player of the Game is Calvert Chaney with 28 points and 8 rebounds. He was a perfect 7 for 7 from the line and 10 of 18 from the floor. Alan Henderson also had a strong game with 19 points and 6 rebounds. Calvert Chaney, 29 for Chaney. A season-high 30 points for Chaney. He had 29 during the Big Ten season at Iowa. Indiana with its largest lead, 13 points. Indiana, 37 seconds away from a date with Florida State in the Sweet 16 in Albuquerque. While we have a moment, we'd like to take this opportunity to thank our NCAA representatives, Gary Cunningham of Fresno State and Joe McGinnis. That's a 3 for Harold Boudreau. Our regional director here in Boise, Boise State athletic director Gene Blaymeyer, and regional manager Herb Kreiner. Max Corbett, a terrific job here as the media coordinator. We'd also like to thank the sports information directors of all 8 schools who played here in Boise for their cooperation. Indiana knows the road to the Final Four. They've traveled the road.
Okay, let's get to the finish quickly now.